Hello and welcome to Adelux on this new Lutron Homeworks QS tutorial, where I will share with you my experience as an independent Lutron programmer. Today, I'd like to show you one of the ways I'm using area scenes at the beginning of a project to program Homeworks QS systems quickly and efficiently. So, without further ado, let's do it. When I start a new Lutron Homeworks QS project, I'm always trying to find ways to quickly program certain sections of my database. This obviously lowers service costs for my clients, and it also allows us to invest this precious time later on more complex aspects of the programming. So to optimize this time, especially at the beginning of the programming process, I tend to use area scenes. This is particularly effective when it comes to quickly program similar Lutron keypads and to make quick changes as well as troubleshooting issues. Let me show you how. This master bedroom area is part of a much larger Lutron Homeworks QS system, but let's just use it as an example. Let's say that all the keypads in a master bedroom are similar. For the moment, we just want them to have the same functionalities, so they are all operational to test the system in the early stages of the commissioning process, and will allow anyone on site to operate the light to a basic level until we got to a more complex lighting scene setting. All the Lutron keypads have three buttons plus a resin lower. At this stage, we just need all keypad buttons to be set to a 100% and 25% lighting level and an off for the room they're in. I guess we are all familiar with this initial programming process. In this master bedroom, for example, we have a keypad by the entrance, left and right side of the bed. First, let's program the buttons on the keypad by the entrance. So here, to program my top button to set the light to 100%, I could either add each circuit one by one at the desired light level, like I'm doing here, or go to the room level and select 100% to automatically add all the circuits in that room to that level. This seems very effective, but the problem is that when I move on to the next keypad, which is blank, I will have to do the same thing all over again. Alternatively, we could copy the keypad and then paste it onto the other ones, which is great as it can allow you to quickly program keypads. But let's say that once you uploaded and tested the program, you realize that 100% is far too bright and that you need to adjust it to 75%, for example. You will have then to do the same thing all over again. Update the keypad settings and then paste that keypad again onto all the others. This can be time consuming with the additional risk of forgetting to update one of the keypads. Remember, this is the early stage of the programming process and I need to remain flexible and avoid wasting time for no reason. So, instead, I will use area scenes. An area scene is a scene that contains all the lighting circuits for that particular room only. And that area scene can be called and used at various places in my database. By default, each room has four scenes and an off scene that are pre-programmed. So, if I select the master bedroom here, I can see that area scene 1 is already set with all the circuits in that particular room to 100%. Area scene 2 is already set to 75%. Area scene 3 is already set to 50%, area scene 4 is already set to 25%, and area off scene has already all the circuits set to off or 0%. And I can add some more if I need to by clicking on the plus sign here. There are a few other parameters that we can play with, but as I mentioned previously, we try to replicate the early stages of the commissioning phase here. So we will keep all the default settings as they are perfect for this example, and I will post a separate tutorial about the other settings for area scenes shortly, and I will add the link in the comment section below. Now, let's go back to my keypad by the master bedroom entrance. This is how I will program this keypad. I'd select my top button, and instead of selecting lighting zone, I'll select lighting areas. This will give me access to my area scene for this particular room. So here, I'm going to directly select master bedroom area scene 2, which, as we now know, has all the circuit in the master bedroom already set to 75%. I left aside the area scene 1 in purples, and I will show you why in a moment. Then, for the middle button, I select master bedroom area scene 4 that has all the circuit set to 25%. And for the bottom button, I select master bedroom area off scene with all the circuits off. So, the reason why I left area scene 1 aside is very simple. Most of the time, especially on projects with a lot of lighting circuits, I found that a full 100% may be too bright for the day-to-day use. On the other hand, I still want the client to be able to access that 100% lighting level for specific use, such as cleaning the room, for example. To do that, on the top button, I will now select the double tap tab, tick the box to allow double tap, and then select master bedroom area scene 1. Therefore, on the day-to-day, when the client will press the top button, she will trigger the master bedroom area scene 2 with all the circuits at 75% or whatever lighting scene I end up programming. This will provide a pleasant, bright lighting level and at the same time save on energy costs. And if for any reason the client needs to bring all the lighting circuits to a full 100%, she can just double tap on the top button. Next, I'll complete the programming of these buttons by adding some engraving information. This may not be the final ones, but it's very useful to know what each button is doing during the programming process. So I'll name the top button bright, the middle one low, and the bottom one off. Once completed, I can now copy this entire keypad and paste it on the keypad on the left side of the bed, and then on the keypad on the right side of the bed. I will also use the same programming method for every keypad in their relevant rooms for the rest of the project. And this is where using area scene can be very convenient. Let's say that once I've uploaded and tested my keypad programming, I've noticed, for example, that my low scene in the master bedroom, which triggered the master bedroom area scene 4, is not low enough. It's slightly too bright. I can just quickly go back to the area scene section, select the master bedroom, then select area scene 4 and change all the lighting level to 10%, for example. At this moment, all the keypad buttons that were referring to that master bedroom area scene 4 have all been updated, all in one single operation, which is great. And this is what I mean by programming my Lutron Homeworks QS system quickly and efficiently. To conclude, the objective here was to quickly program similar keypad buttons at the beginning of a project to basic but functional lighting levels. And this is what we've done. Instead of programming the keypad button by adding lighting circuits one by one at a desired lighting level, we've assigned the relevant area scene to the relevant keypad button. Then we copy that keypad onto the other similar keypads in that room. And as a result, if a lighting scene needs to be changed, this can be done directly in the relevant area scene, and automatically that scene will be updated throughout the database. All the keypads using that scene will be updated all at once. By using this method, we've optimized the whole programming process to allow future changes in a quick and efficient manner. Voilà, there you have it. How to quickly program keypads using area scenes. I hope you found this tutorial useful, and if you are using area scenes in a different way, please let us know in the comment section below, as well as any question you may have. Please don't forget to like and subscribe so you can be updated when the next video is released. Good luck, and talk to you again on the next tutorial.